discussion of the front of the arm. We will reflect the skin of the front of arm. And you can see this is the fatty layer. We have already removed the deep fascia. It is also called the brachial fascia. Now you can see above to the this deep fascia, which is covers to the biceps and whole of the arm, and it divides the arm into the two compartments, and it goes internally, and it medial intermuscular septum and lateral intermuscular septum. So the arm divide into the two compartment. This is the front of the arm and this is the back of the arm by the two intermuscular septum, medial and as well as lateral intermuscular septum. But we have removed the things. Now muscles of the front of the arm, there are three muscles of the front of arm. We have already reflect the pectoralis major. Here you can see this muscle. This is the coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis arise from the tip of the coracoid process of the scapula to the upper one third of the medial side of the medial border of the humerus. There is an insertion of the coracobrachialis, and this coracobrachialis pierced by the nerve. It is called the musculocutaneous nerve. This is a musculocutaneous nerve. It is a branch of the lateral cord of the brachial plexus. And this musculocutaneous nerve, later on it between the biceps and brachialis muscles, and it enter inside the forearm and it supplies the skin of the lateral side of the forearm. This is a lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm, and it is along with the cephalic vein. So this is the lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm. It is a continuation of the medial it is a continuation of the musculocutaneous nerve. Another thing, this is the biceps muscles. Biceps means two, a head. It has a long head and a short head. Long head, which is arise from the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula, and short head, which is arise from the along with it coracobrachialis, which is arise from the tip of the coracoid process of the scapula, and the biceps, which is inserted on the radial tuberosity, and it is the main chief flexor of the elbow, as well as it is the supinator of the supination of the forearm. The biceps, it is also inserted into the deep fascia as a bicipital aponeurosis. This is a bicipital aponeurosis, and the tendon, which is inserted on the radial tuberosity of the just below to the head of the radius. Another third muscles, here you can see between below to the biceps, there is a brachialis muscles. It is a muscles which arise from the lower half of the humerus of the anteromedial and anterolateral surface of the humerus, and this brachialis muscles, which is inserted on the coracoid process of the ulna. It is also the part, there is ulnar tuberosity. Ulnar tuberosity, it is a part of the coracoid process. It is the most prominent part of the coracoid process. So brachialis, which is arise from the lower half of the humerus, anteromedial and anterolateral surface of the humerus, and it is inserted on the coracoid process of the ulna, and the most prominent part, it is called the ulnar tuberosity, and it is the strongest chief flexor muscles of the front of the front elbow. It is the chief flexor muscles of the elbow. Third thing we have discussed about the previously, we already discussed the axillary artery. Axillary artery, it is a continuation of the subclavian artery at the outer border of the first rib, and axillary artery, which is end at the lower border of the teres major muscles. Here you can see this is the teres major muscle. This one is the teres major muscles. This is the lower border of the teres major muscles, and it becomes continues as a brachial artery. And this brachial artery, which is terminated inside the cuboidal fossa into the two terminal branches, radial on the lateral side there is a radial artery, and medial side it is called the ulnar artery. So the brachial artery, it is the begin at the lower border of the teres major, and it is end at the terminate into the elbow as a ulnar and radial artery. Now the brachial artery inside the brachium means arm. So that's why it's a name given the brachial artery. The brachial artery, it gives the first branch. This is the profunda brachii artery. This profunda brachii artery, you can see here, this is the profunda brachii artery. It goes along with the radial nerve. It is the continuation of the posterior cord. And the profunda brachii and radial nerve, which is passed into the lower triangular space. This is the lower triangular space. This horizontal, my middle finger, it is the teres minor. The lower one, index finger, this is the teres major. And the vertical, my index finger, it is the longed up triceps. And this, my middle finger, it is the shaft of the humerus. So there are three space which is formed. Upper triangular, this is the quadrangular, means quadra means four boundary, and lower triangular space. So inside the lower triangular space, there is a passing the radial nerve, along with it profunda brachii artery. Inside the quadrangular space, which is bounded above by the teres minor, below by the teres major, medially it is bounded by the longed up triceps, and laterally by the shaft of humerus. And this quadrangular space, which passes the quadrangular space, which passes the two structure, this forceps, which is the two structures, it passes the axillary nerve as well as posterior circumflex humeral artery. And the lower triangular space, which is bounded by the above by the teres major, medially by the longed up triceps, and laterally by the shaft of humerus. So you can see here, this is the radial nerve, and this radial nerve, which is passes along with it, there is a profunda brachii artery. This is the profunda brachii artery, and which is bounded above by the teres major, below by the above by the teres major, laterally by the shaft of humerus, and medially this muscle, it is the longed up triceps muscle. And you can see, this is the radial nerve enter inside the lower triangular space, and then it enter inside the radial groove of the humerus, and it supplies to the extensor compartment of the arm as well as forearm. Now the brachial artery, we will discuss the brachial artery. It gives the first branch, it is the profunda brachii. After that, it here, this is the nutrient branch of the profunda brachii, nutrient branch of the brachial artery. It also gives the muscular branches, and it also gives the two another branches, superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral artery, which makes the anastomosis on the medial side of the elbow joint. It goes downwards. Superior ulnar collateral artery, it is passed along with the ulnar nerve. This is the, you can see, this is the ulnar nerve. So superior ulnar collateral artery, it is passes along with the ulnar nerve. So the brachial artery, it begins at the lower border of the teres major, and it terminate into the cuboidal fossa as a larger ulnar artery and smaller brachial artery. But in this limb, there is a variation, and it is higher division of the brachial artery. It is divided, the brachial artery, inside the upper half into the middle of the arm. It divide into the radial and ulnar artery. So here you can see, this is the radial artery, which crosses the median nerve from medial to lateral side, and it is goes along on the lateral sides, while the ulnar artery, which is goes along with the medial to the median nerve. Normally the structure inside the cuboidal fossa, this is the cuboidal fossa, which is bounded by the, to draw the imaginary line from the two epicondyles of the humerus, medially it is bounded by the, this is the teres, pronator teres, and laterally it is bounded by the brachioradialis muscles. So meeting point of this, it is the apex of the cuboidal fossa, and the imaginary line, it is the, to draw from the two epicondyle, it is the base of the cuboidal fossa. And inside the cuboidal fossa, most medially there is a biceps muscles, most medially by the median nerve. Then there is a brachial artery, but here in this case there is a not brachial artery, and but the biceps tendon. And laterally there is a this nerve, it is called the superficial branch of the radial nerve. normally the content from medial to lateral, median nerve, then brachial artery, then biceps, and then radial nerve. But in this case, the most medially there is a ulnar artery, then median nerve, then biceps tendon, then radial nerve, and then there is a tendon superficial branch of the radial nerve. So this is about to the brachial artery. Once again, this is the profunda brachii branch. This is the nutrient branches, and laterally, medially there is a superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral branches, and this is the muscular branches, and this is the terminations of the brachial artery into the middle half of the arm. It divides into the ulnar and radial artery. This is the ulnar artery, larger one, and smaller one is the radial artery. So this is the higher division in this limbs, and this is about to the front of the arm.